Today I'm going to show you how to replace the charging port in your iPhone 6 Plus. If you want to check out any of the other repair videos, click on the links in the front of this video. Here's the iPhone 6 Plus. To get to the charging port, we have to go through the screen. So we're going to remove the two screws at the bottom called pentalobe screws. If you need any tools or replacement parts, check in the video description below. I will link everything for you there. Take your suction cup and put it on the screen and lift up a little bit. Then you can take your pry tool and lift up on the frame of the glass and pry against the frame of the phone, and that'll lift the screen off. Be super careful because the screens are very fragile and you don't want to bend it or it will crack. Don't bend the screen past 90 degrees because these ribbon cables will get stressed. Take out the five screws, remove the metal plate, and then pop up each of these little ribbon cables. There's four of them and you can kind of treat them like Legos. They just unsnap from the motherboard. Once you've unsnapped all four, the screen will come loose. And you can see all the components there, the earpiece, the home button. Set that aside somewhere safe. Then there's three screws next to the battery. Undo all three of those and pop off the little metal bracket. Then unclip the battery from the motherboard. Then there's a ribbon cable right here that's hiding another screw. So lift that up and then unscrew that screw, set it aside, and make sure you stay organized with these screws. That's super important. Unsnap the wire cable, and then the vibrator motor will slip out from underneath that ribbon cable. Pull the wire cable from the vibrator motor, and then you can see here that the two contact points is where it goes on the ribbon cable for the charging port. Anyway, pull out the wire cable. Two more screws down at the bottom of the loudspeaker. Undo those, set them aside, keep them organized. And then the loudspeaker will come out from the phone as well. So this is what plays your music and your ringtone and stuff like that. You can clean it out if there's ever any metal shaving stuck inside of there because there's a big magnet. There's two contact points that connect to the ribbon cable down at the bottom. Then there's a little square metal bracket, put that somewhere safe. Two screws holding the shield down for the charging port. Undo that. Set that aside next to the two screws you just took out. And then there's five more screws. The blue one is for the microphone. The little bracket that holds that in place, this little guy, set that next to the screw you took out. Two screws down for the headphone jack and then two screws on the other side of the phone as well. Keep those organized and then lift off the wire cable as well. You'll need to move that to your new charging port. Then you can kind of use a plastic tool and scrape underneath the ribbon cable for the charging port and lift that out of the phone. You want to be pretty careful with it just in case your new charging port doesn't work. You can put your old one back in for the time being. Lift that out and then be super careful with the headphone jack and the microphone. They're kind of embedded in the frame of the phone. Once you've lifted those out from the frame, you get the charging port itself. Now, there might be a little rubber boot on the end of the microphone that you need to transfer over to your new one. It just depends on if your new charging port comes with that or not. So make sure you've transferred over everything that needs to be transferred over. Pop the headphone jack back into the frame of the phone, same with the microphone. Just kind of press it in there and make sure the hole lines up with the hole in the frame. Then you can take the microphone bracket, slip that back into place. And if you need to pause it here, you can. Make sure all these screws go back into the same holes they came out of. Wire cable goes down on the little connection. Just line it up over the top and press it in. Get that shield back on there with the two screws. Once that's done, you can get the loudspeaker. I've already put the little square metal bit, attached it to it, and then your wire cable goes underneath in that little groove. Once you've positioned all that, you can screw in the little screw at the corner of the battery, and then the other screw down at the other corner of the phone on the loudspeaker. Clip the wire cable into the vibrator motor. Get that hidden screw back in place. Clip down the ribbon cable, clip down the wire cable, press it right down on top of the little connection, and then you can clip down the battery. Pretty straightforward. Get the top clip on there, and then get the other two screws, and then also the screw down at the bottom of the vibrator motor. A lot of steps to remember. Here's the screen, and then there's those four little connections that go right back onto the motherboard. Remember, we're treating them like Legos, so you line them up right over the top of the connection and then press it down into place. Pretty straightforward. If you end up with lines in your screen, it means one of these connections wasn't pressed down correctly. So turn off your phone again, pop off the screen, make sure they're all pressed down correctly. You want to make sure you do it right. I actually, once I get them all pressed down, I turn on the phone before actually closing the screen down so I don't have to risk breaking the screen as I pull it off again. So you can see the screen's still up, everything's working fine, no lines. Turn the phone off because you definitely don't want to be working on it while the phone is on. That was just to test the screen out. Anyway, get the metal bracket back on there with those five screws. And then you want to line the top of the screen up with the frame on the phone. Just kind of press it in so it's flush. And then once that's in, then you can line the rest of the phone up with the screen and it'll just kind of clip down. Make sure to be super gentle with it because you don't want to break your screen. The more gentle you are, the better. Just be super careful. I will link all the replacement parts and tools in the video description below. Get those two bottom screws in there after you turn the phone back on. And you're set. If you have any questions, make sure to leave them in the comments. Feel free to like this video if it helped you. And don't forget to subscribe. It does mean a lot to me. Thanks for watching.